Ago, I requested for the deferment of presentation of Mr. Sandoval. He is now present before this August body. So may we invite Mr. Sandoval to take the friendship. Mr. Chairman,
okay.
Members of this August body, members of the media guests, ladies and gentlemen. We have today as our distinguished guest, Director Sandy Martilla Hobilla. He is the youngest child of Mr. Sandy Hobilla, former Municipal Treasurer of Pili Camarines Sur, and President of the Municipal Treasurers Association of the Philippines, MUNTAP, and the late Milborga M. Hobilla, former Municipal Councilor and Municipal Treasurer of Sipukot, Camarines Sur. Director Sandy Hobilla is a native of Sipukot, Camarines Sur, an alumnus of the St. Joseph School of Naga City. He is young and energetic at 35 years, who previously worked as a special technical assistant of the Office of Secretary of the Department of Agriculture. Is still connected with the same department, he was issued an special order dated November 21, 2013 by Secretary Alcala as Director of the Program Support Office of the Philippine Rural Development Project, Luzon Cluster B, which covers Regions 4A, 4B, and Region 5. He graduated from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, in Laguna with Master's and Bachelor's Degree in Agriculture Economics. Passed the licensure examination for agriculturist, garnering 9th place among the 2,520 examinees throughout the country. After passing the said examinations with flying colors, he worked at the UPLB and Sharka as researcher, research associate, and research supervisor, in which he gained prominence in research works, planning and project development, designing and packaging. He started his work with the Department of Agriculture in 2008 as agriculture production specialist under the Infrastructure for Rural Productivity Enhancement Sector Project, the Development Bank, the Department of Agriculture, the Oriental Consultants Company Limited, and the Orient Integrated Development Consultants. In 2011, he was assigned as a Special Technical Assistant with the Office of the Secretary of Agriculture, whose primary task was to coordinate with the DBM, NEDA, and other members and representatives of the Rural Development Cabinet subcluster on the coconut and fishery-focused convergence programs and the World Bank on matters pertaining to the Philippine Rural Development Program, as well as to oversee the preparation and finalization of the program feasibility studies in the manual of operations. Until November 2013, he was also designated program coordinator for the Luzon B program support of the Office of Philippine Rural Development Program, where his main function was to assist the program director in overseeing the preparatory and pre-implementation activities of the program. Mr. Chairman, Camarines Sur and the Bicol region has one son to be proud of in the person of Mr. Sandy M. Hobilla, who was appointed by His Excellency President Binding Luis Aquino III to the position of Director 3 of the Philippine Fiber Industry Development Authority on November 13, 2013. He took his oath of office before the Agriculture Secretary Proceso J. Alcala on November 21, 2013. It is our hope, Mr. Chairman, that with Mr. Sandy Hobilla's appointment as Director of the Philippine Fiber Industry Development Authority will certainly signal the revitalization of our dying abaca industry in the province. Mr. Hobilla's personal achievements, it is but fitting and a singular honor for this August body to present to him Resolution Number 216, Series of 2014, which reads as follows. Resolution extending congratulations to Mr. Sandy Martilla Hobilla for being appointed Deputy Director, Director 3 of the Philippine Fiber Industry Development Authority by His Excellency President Binigno S. Aquino III. Mr. Chairman, I have the honor and singular privilege to present to you and to this August body and to all our guests, Director Sandy M. Hobili.
The chair would like to declare a 2-minute recess in order for the body to confer the resolution of recognition to Director Sandy Hobili. Recess for 2 minutes. The members, please come forward. Come on. Session resumes. Honorable Manny Noble, please proceed.
Mr. Chairman, thank you. So, pertaining to that explanation of the representative from the PRC, so based on that itemized mga bill na may mga part pala dyan na direct doon sa katulad sa grid, meron din binabayaran sa grid, national grid, meron din doon. And then, paano naman man, limbawa, yung salary? So, sa salary po, baga, hindi nyo control kung how much yung pinakaano ng mga empleyado. Because sometimes, ibang co-op, siyempre, hindi, mayroon din kayong ano doon, yung control doon sa overstaff. Limbawa, siyempre, pag nakita mo doon sa itemized, pertaining to that salary, paano kung nag-apaw doon sa cooperative? So, meaning, kung nag-apaw ang mga empleyado, i-charge sa amin. Parang gano'n, hindi rin. Paano, ano naman? Yes.
Sa bawat... Please, let the... from the PRC, who would you like to answer first?
So,
from the PRC.
From the PRC.
Let me answer. Then next is attorney.
Actually, yun pong actual payroll nila kapag pumunta sa amin upang magpa-review ng kanilang gastusin. At magiging reflect, magre-reflect yon sa kanilang tariffs o yung distribution, supply and material, ano po yun. Chine-check po namin yan. Kapag overstaff po, based on NEA guidelines o sa iba pa mang pamantayan, tinatanggal po namin yon for rate-making purposes, ang tawag namin. Kahit po yung mga benepisyo, halimbawa, kunwari lang po, nagbigay sila ng 13th month, pinapayagan naman po yun, lahat tayo.
Yes, yes.
Eh kunwari yung isang co-op nagbigay ng 14, 15, pag po yung dumaan sa review namin, tinatanggal po namin yon. At yung rate, yung dapat lalabas sa rate, ay wala na yung dagdag na gastos na hindi pinapayagan sa rate making. Although, kung halimbawa may saving sila, at maganda naman yung performance ng mga empleyado nila at meron pang pondo, pwede po nila yung ibigay. Pero pag na-review po uli namin yun, nagpanibagong application po sila, makikita po uli yun, tatanggalin uli namin yun. So ibig sabihin, meron po kaming cap sa mga gastusin, meron kaming pinapayagan kapag nire-review namin yung mga taripa nila at tinatanggal yon doon sa nagre-reflect sa inyo dyan. So, paano sila nagkakaroon ng savings? Ang kanila pong sales kasi, ang trend po ng sales, kahit hindi sa kuryente, tumataas po yan. So, pagtaas po na, nakakakuha sila ng konti, doon pwede silang magbigay ng magdagdag ng gastusin. Pero for regulatory purposes, babalik uli kami doon kapag mayroong application, and then doon lang sa tamang gastusin, doon kami magbabase nung ilalabas namin na desisyon, ano yung distribution, supply, and metering. I'm mentioning distribution, supply, and metering kasi yun po yung napupunta lang sa kooperatiba niyo. So yun po yung upper portion kasi, ang tawag po namin doon ay pass-through. Kung ano yung singil nila, dapat ibabayad lang nila yun. Babayad nila sa NGCP, sa power supplier, pati po yung portion ng systems loss, actually yan ay binabayad din sa power portion.
So dito manage ano sir. What about sa yung allowable na system loss. Ilan ba ano ang Energy Regulatory Commission po? Meron din kayo standard pertaining to that ano?
Meron din po kami ano, actually ang ano po diyan ay merong 13% cap sa mga kooperatiba. So kung lumagpas ng 13, bawa, ang pangit talaga yung sistema ng co-op, nasabing co-op, bawa, 14% o 20%, from 14 to 20% na kanilang na-incur na loss, hindi na po nila yan pwedeng bawiin sa tao. Hanggang 13 lang po ang...
13 lang ang allowable.
Nasa sa batas naman po yun.
So in the event na ganito, no, babalikan natin sa co-op, halimbawa yung ano nila, yung ceiling nila from 13 up to umabot sila ng mga 18. So nag-request sa inyo ngayon for hindi rin cover.
Hindi rin cover.
So anong ginagawa ng mga co-op?
We'll have to subsidize
manager.
Any figure in excess of 13, it will be subsidized by the cooperative. In the event that the system cost will be lower than the 13, we can only charge the lower. Sabihin natin 12%. If the actual is 12%, we can only charge 12%. We cannot charge 13%. So the limit is 13%. But then, doon po sa, ano, doon sa distribution charge, that is actually value, because it is actually pre-approved. In the process, in the event that there will be overstaffing, we cannot charge anything beyond what was already approved. So kung approved kami ng 5 million and only then, when we applied, we are up to the 5 million only, no more, no less.
So based on that Energy Regulatory Commission, ang naka-confuse pa kaya sa co-op, under the supervision of NEA. So ang NEA ba, di ba, parehas kong government, ano? Ano ang role ng NEA na pwede rin mag-intervention, yung papasok sa inyo? May mga instant ba ang NEA nakikialam din sa mga ganon sa Energy Regulatory Commission? Pagalimbawa, dahil alam ko yung co-op under the supervision of NEA na nasa-sanction din yung mga co-op. So ano ang role ngayon ng National Electrification pertaining to that na parehas tayong government?
Bagamat hindi po ako taga-NEA, hindi po ako authorized na mag-represent or sumagot. Pero ang amin pong mandato ay kami sa taripa, sila sa administrative. And management ng co-op, maliban, pati na rin CDA yata, may bagong law. So, yung mga kooperatiba po na under nila, kapag may dispute or mayroong election or iba pa, mga loans, sila naman po ang...
So, NEA, alam po sa NEA.
Pero yung rate na ipapasa nila, yung nakalagay dyan sa bill, yun po ang sa ERC.
Yung ang ERC.
Tsaka po yung pagsunod sa grid code at tsaka yung sa open access, yun naman po ang sa ERC. So, pag may hati at
may... Meaning nga, ano, sir? Pag alimbawa, doon i-remit natin yung ibang mga gastusin ano, sa iba-ibang itemized dyan, nakadagdag dyan. So, direct ninyong re-remit na yan, iba-ibang ano yan, account, parang ganon? Paano man?
Mayor, papasok always, kakagawin ng intervention ni mayor, in the event na merong mismanagement. So, sabihin natin, kasi if there is by mismanagement, there'll be losses sa part ng co-op. So, in the event, pagka there is losses, hindi meron kami hindi mabayaran na generators. So, doon papasok ni mayor. So, to assure that na yung operation ng co-op would be smooth sailing.
So, like the case sa Kasoraico 2, as of now, under tayo ngayon ni, ano, ng project supervisor?
Meron po kaming PS ngayon, PS din, dahil umalis po si, ano, si Mrs. Barameda, in-appoint siyang acting general manager.
Acting general manager.
So, although there is already a process ng selection ng GM.
So, as of now, meron kayong acting general manager?
Acting general manager in the person of Mr. Adlao.
So, ngayon, ano ang role ngayon ng board of director? It is consider pa rin yung board, nandiyan pa rin, existing pa rin ang board ninyo?
Ang alam ko po, meron pa kami existing na 3. Although by the law, if yung 6 would be reconsidered, then it would be 9 again.
Kasi based on my experience, during the time naging director din ako sa Kasoraico 3, I think one, at the time na ano kami na under the control of Nayan, na ano kami na take over. So yung rules ng board supposed to be na suspend. So ano ang status ngayon sa Kasoraico 2?
Meron po kami yung board. Kaya lang, because of the fact na merong hindi, no, after yung election, merong hindi, yung anim, hindi na sila nakapag,
kasi sa dalawa ang pag-take over sa mga co-op. Pag sinabi mong full take over, wala tayong board of director under demand of representative from NEA. So ngayon, nakukonfuse ako pertaining to that, ano ang role ni OIC General Manager Adlao? Ano ba na supersede yung board or totally ano may limitation niya yung board natin?
Meron pa kaming board.
Meron pa rin so, yung board.
Ano lang siya para...
So yung board niya, nag-existing pa yung board ninyo.
Okay,
so Mr. Adlao, being the acting general manager, nagsisita as ex-officio member of the, under the...
Yeah, po.
The setup. So relevant to that Kasoraico 3, no, Kasoraico 3. Kasoraico 3, during the time of barangay election and local election, I think almost 5 members of the board nag-resign. So I think sa Kasoraico 3, ma'am, almost 4 na lang yung natitirang ano natin, representative. So I heard that last time in radio information, mga news, na mayroon na pala tayong composition of board of director. That composition of board of director, I think, hindi alam ng mga consumer kung paano yung manners ng selection. Yun ang pinaka-question namin, no, madam? So ngayon, gusto ko lang matanong kung outthrough ng bago natin board of director in the person of Mr. Gilbert Villar. Yun na ba ang ano natin, bagong board president?
Sa ngayon po, siya po ang talagang board president. Pero yung pong sa part ng mga empleyado at saka yung pong ano, hindi pa po sila dumadaan sa screening committee.
So,
iyan kaya iyan po ang kino-question din po ng mga empleyado.
So meaning,
na
meaning,
bakit sila biglang naupo as board
members? Sige, ganito ah. Ako, madam, ito ah. Ang composition ng selection, alam ninyo yan ah, composition of selection. Sa board of director, once na nag-appoint tayo, subject for approval ni Nanaya. So ang baliktad ngayon, ang composition ng board ngayon, pinag-appoint ng at least 4 na member ng board pagkatapos re-recognize sa board ano nera session board meeting pagkatapos ipinagpasa na daw sa NEA, pwedeng mapanisan kami ng ano ng opisina ninyo na sabi daw that information sabi yun daw ang order ng NEA na dapat mag-appoint ng mga representative from BUI, then dalawa sa Iriga, dalawa sa Napua. So yun ang ano ngayon, nakukonfuse ngayon sa Kasoraico 3. Ano yan? Recognized na madam?
Pagka ganun po na sabi natin kina selection, it would be from the M-Shop. Kasi sabi parang tawag nila is M-Shop. This would be voted upon by the LGUs. So kung saan district yun, pipili yung LGU ng 6. From the 6, karoon ng selection ng NEA. Kung sino ang mapili dun sa 6, yun ang naiging...
But I think in
Kregonan... Ang approval doon, we'll just from the LGU itself.
I think sa Rinconada alone, alam ko, isa lang yung pinag-recommend at that time, pinag-appoint, pinag-recommend support, then pinag-recognize na ng board. So, mayroon tayong opposition, madam, ano, pertaining sa, ano natin, sa mga, I think, supervisory group sa Kasoreco, nag-oppose, and then the employees union na nag-contra kayo doon sa appointment. Pero, as of now, gusto ko lang maklear kung official na pong nagre-report itong mga board of director na to.
Alam ko po, nagkakontak na po sila ng mga board meetings at tumatanggap na rin po sila ng per gem nila.
Na, so, it is now considered legal on the part?
Alam ko po, kumbaga sa dinala na po ni Deputy Basig yung confirmation daw. Pero sa hindi pa sila, sir, na hindi pa officially kasi nga nagki-clearance pa sila. Kumbaga sa nahuli po yung pag...
So, alam ko ang manners ng selection, i-endorse ka ngayon ng mga local NGO, ng government organization. Suppose, religious group, education sector, and then senior citizen. I think we have almost mga 10 composition of non-government organization. I-endorse ngayon ng mga tao, iba-ibang sector, iba-ibang tao na i-endorse. Ang problema ngayon, ma'am, I heard, ito, ang nakita ko, sa totoo lang, gusto nga si mismong si Manager Claro, na doon mismo daw sa loob pa ng Kasoreco, yung composition. Alam ko, hindi yan sa loob. I think, magmaman yan mismo by endorsement through non-government organization. So kaya ako, nag-uupos ako, I prepare to oppose that appointed position pertaining to that then. Marami pong nagkukontra na hindi po tama doon sa ginawa. Kaya ako magpre-prepare din ako being the chairman of the Committee on Energy na mag-oppose ako in representation of the Rinconada areas. Considering that yung ginawa hindi po tama doon sa sistema. So, mayroon akong letter addressed to National Electrification Commission, Electrification, NEA, na nag-oopos kami doon nga sa move na yung mga appointed position na ngayon as per your, ma'am, nagre-receive na ngayon ng fair dime that consider madam illegal on the part dahil po nga hindi pa recognized on the part of National Electrification Administration.
Sir, thank you po sa move nyo na yon kasi kumbaga sa magiging malaking tulong din po doon sa parte ng mga empleyado. Kasi pumunta na po doon noong isang araw yung representative po ng union para nga po questionin yung appointment nila.
And then the last to question my Mr. Presiding Officer address to that Kasoreco representative. So, gusto ko lang maklear. Kayo po ba sa co-op ninyo, nag-file po kayong petition increase sa Energy Regulatory Commission?
Sa Kasoreco 3 po, wala.
Wala. What about sa Kasoreco 2?
Wala rin po. As actually sabi nga kanina, it's explained ng ERC, it's actually brought about by the pass-on rate from the generators. Kung tumaas kasi yung bili namin, eventually, tataas din yung benta namin.
Yes. What about sa Kasoreco po?
Sa ngayon po, wala pa po.
So, meaning po, sir, maski po hindi sila mag-submit pertaining to that sabi ninyo, so, alimbawa na mayroon nga, gusto ko lang po kayang maklear sa inyo, sa opisina ninyo, kung mayroon talagang I heard kasi na mayroon talagang petition na request yung mga co-op sa energy. Ano ba itong Kamsur, Kamarines Cooperative? Mayroon po silang nakasalang na petition increase for that matter?
Sa kasalukuyan po, ang application po na nakapile sa amin ay pagbabago ng tarifa para sa taong 2014 i-implement ay ang Kasoreco 1, yung tariff light path. Pero wala pa pong desisyon ng komisyon noon. So hanggat di po lumalabas yun, ay hindi po gagalaw ang kanilang taripa. So next year naman po, kasoreko 3 and 4, periodic po kasi yon, para hindi sila sabay-sabay nagpapile, para marireview namin lahat. And then sa susunod na taon pa, ang kasoreko 3, kasi may grouping po sila noon. Pero yung pong lumalabas ngayon na pagbabago ng taripa, explain po nung kasama ko dito, na ito po ay may kinalaman malamang doon sa generation and generation cost. Okay, bigay ko po ang kung papahintulutan okay, po ng si Mr. Lacanienta po.
Okay, please introduce yourself before. I am Royce Lacanienta, Senior Energy Regulation Officer, assigned at the Investigation and Enforcement Division of the ERC. So malamang ang pinag-uusapan natin dito ay yung biglang taas ng generation charge from 5.53 sa kasoreko po yata yun eh, naging 9 something. So yung increase na yun, eh, automatic po yun eh. Hindi kailangan ng approval ng commission kasi may rules po tayo dyan na yung tinatawag natin yung AGRA, na yung lahat sa generation portion yung AGRA at saka sa system loss, na lahat na authorized ang mga distribution utilities na mag-adjust ng rate monthly. Kaya lang dito sa generation charge, kaya biglang lumaki ng todo yung ano, yung increase sa generation, dahil yung kanilang isang supplier ay nag-force shutdown for 1 month, na bigla silang na-expose sa wholesale electricity spot market, na sumabay naman ng shutdown din sa ibang parte ng Pilipinas, na kaya lahat ng mga na malaki ang exposure sa WESM ay ang laki ng increase sa generation. So hindi lang Kasoreko po ang affected dito, pati ang Pangasinan 3 Electric Cooperative, ang Tarlac 2, meron pang mga private utilities, Meralco, Dagupan Electric, so matataas ang increase nila. So lahat kasi ng mataas ang exposure sa WESM na ano sila?
Yeah, WESM is government owned.
Private siya.
Ang WESM?
Wholesale Electricity Spot Market.
I thought WESM is the
president is
the secretary.
Pero
energy.
Pero yung WESM is hindi government yan eh. Private siya.
WESM is private?
Private ang WESM. Na created by law. Pero private siya.
Are you sure?
Yes.
That it is private?
Private ang WESM.
Para sa chairman of the board, they said it's the chairman of the secretary of energy.
Secretary of Energy, pero
yes, private. Secretary of Energy, the chairman of the board.
Yes, private siya. Para siya yung ano, yung...
So if that is private, may sarili ba siyang investment dyan, si secretary? Para maging chairman siya?
Wala.
Oh.
Pero yung ano, yung classification niya private, para siya yung Philippine...
Say for example, the Secretary Petilla, is he sitting there as Mr. Petilla or as Secretary of Energy?
As Secretary
Whoever is the Secretary of Energy will sit there as the chairman.
Mm.
Oh, how will it be a private, not a government owned corporation or whatever you call that?
Ah, okay. Yung WESM kasi, sir, is operated by the Philippine Electricity Market Corporation, which is private. Pero ang board niyan is yung PEM board, headed by Secretary of Energy. Magkaiba si PEMC at saka si PEM board.
So before WESM, mayroon pa yung Philippine?
Wala.
Where does the money go? Level the increase, the sudden increase.
Sa,
it goes to WESM?
Sa generators. Si PEMC, sila lang yung nagmapara siyang Philippine ano, Stock Exchange. Ang WESM is parang PSE. trading ang commodity sa OSM is electricity, ang commodity sa stock exchange is
so parang broker.
Hindi,
ang OSM
hindi broker, siya yung market. Siya yung market.
So siya ang market. Mm-hmm. So yung increase yung binili ng Kasoreco, dapat nag-shutdown yung sinisisi yung OSM. Yung increase na for something na ganon, saan na pupunta?
Sa generators.
Hindi sa OSM?
Hindi sa OSM. Ang sa OSM ito, meron lang mga fees. Dahil sa, para sa operation ng OSM, may fees na binabayaran ng mga participants.
Anong mga fees na yon na
market fees?
Na kinukuha. How do you compute the market fees?
Yung market fees.
Is there a certain percentage, an amount, what?
Hindi ako familiar sa market fees kasi,
who are the generators of the, under OSM? Kahit sino, pwede niyang i-plug in.
Lahat ng power generators are
like Kasoreco 2, who are the players that sudden increase? Who are the players there under OSM? Na doon ang nag-distribute?
Masinlok.
Masinlok?
Masinlok. Bachman.
Before, nung pumasok yung Masinlok, ano dati ang Kasoreco 2?
NPC.
NPC. So maraming players doon.
Maraming players.
So pag sinabi mong West, maraming players na involved. So the money goes to Masinlok, yung mga iba yung mga
lahat mga generators.
Fee lang ang nasa OSM?
Fee lang, fee.
Sigurado ka yan?
Fee lang.
So siguro ma-research ka natin siguro. Honorable Noble, are you true? Or?
Okay, I have no other inquiry, Mr. Chairman, but the other, I think the other members of the board, the other.
Is there
colleagues also? I have no question pertaining to that invitation. Before we proceed to that, thank you very much, sir, for being with us today, and then the representative from the Kasoreco. Any other members also? Would you mind to?
Majority floor leader? Mr. Majority Floor Leader. Floor Leader, what is now the pressure of the Majority Floor Leader?
Actually, Mr. Chairman, mayo lang man. Ay, ikaw.
Honorable Nelson Bulla, you are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Tigahan ako ta si Manager Adlaw, kundi mayo, siguro may pobya kay Board Member Nabal. Nasa dito po sa bagoy ni Guyan, supplier ng Kasoreco to, may report ka na gayon mga panahon na nagkaigong shutdown naman sa mga supplier kang Kasoreco. Kaya nagkaigong adjustment naman sa presyo, tapos nagperitan sindang maglaog sa WSM.
Pag sali po katong shutdown kang Bachman, eventually, ma-force kami magkuha sa WSM kasi we ought to supply our consumers. Though yung sinasabi ng force is actually being questioned already by Kasoreco 2. Kasi nga, ang sinasabi nila is what happened was actually a forced outage. Na sabi ko nga, duman sa surat ko sa inda, I already gave my opinion sa management. It was never kapo a forced outage dahil ikaw sinaling notice. So something that na under their control is never a forced outage. So it's actually a planned outage. So in the event na ganaon tapo niyo against BGI, we'll be actually filing the dispute. I don't know kung na-file na, but we will be filing the dispute. In the event that we nag-ganaon yan, the power rate could be somewhere 10 to 11 pesos only, not 15, not 17. So, ako nga po, in my capacity as a South Area Manager, I would like to call on the brilliant minds, the lawyers of the Sangguniang Panlalawigan, that we rally against this cause so that we may actually help
your constituents, which are actually our consumers, to be unburdened with this power rate hike because of the fact that kung mapatunayan ito po na talagang bakutong forced outage, and even si the Pelican plant outage, then it follows that BGI should actually suffer the burden. I already computed the same. It's actually 195 million ang cost to be burdened by the BGI.
Before you proceed, Honorable Julia, I would like to inform the body that Manager Abunal is an applicant as a general manager of Kasoreco 2.
Pwede magabangon ang Kasoreco 2?
Yes.
Gusto ko lang pong maraman sa ako yan. Ansarong kooperatiba sa iyong supplier, ikuan yung kontrata na sa loob ng sarong taon ngaya, ikaw ngayon bakman ang masupply sa moya, agad sa moyang kung pirang porsintong dapat maitao sa kooperatiba. Ano po, mayo nakapalaman sa kontrata na kung sagaling mag shutdown ang sarong ang supplier, nasindaan mahanap katong dailin da pwedeng maisupply naman sa kooperatiba dahil sinda may kakontrata na sinasupplier at kan power kong pirama na porsinto ang dadaroon niya sa kooperatiba sa loob ng sarong taon. Mayo po kaya ang Kasoreco 2 na nakapalaman sa kontrata?
Actually po, igungali po eh. Kailangan ang pag-invoke nila is actually the maintenance allowance. Na pigsurat ko na yan po yan na the maintenance allowance is never available to them on the account of kung forced outage, di ba sabi ta, that should be outside of your control. The fact that they gave notice, it follows na pwede mong control mo eh. Pwede mong sabihin na iisug ko na yun sa January kaysa December, di ba? Because that is never forced. Kasi by the act of the notice, yung sabihin, kung nag-notice kang pitcha otso, ayaw ba yung size, di pwede mo siyang iisug ko ta. Ano? Di ko ta, di bang ko ta na expose ang Kasoreco 2. Ngunyan, they opted to shut down with a notice ang pag-availing na is a planned outage. Ngunyan po, duman sa kontrata, nakalaan po duman is that the planned outage should be submitted 30 days prior to the start of the calendar year. They po sila nag-submit. So it follows na mayon silang planned outage, so it follows na mayon silang the fact that they available sa ilang plan, they said available ang force, BGI should suffer the burden and not the consumers of Kasoreco 2, which are actually your constituents. So dapat po, kung matabangan tano, alam ko may kanapon ng brilliant minds in this sanggunian. Gulpilya po ding ding mga maray na bugado. Siguro tabangan ta ang Kasoreco para bibisa laban na ni para may pababata ang consumer ang power rate kang November sa December. Salamat.
Eh, pasara po yan sa nakulang bagay. Tapag sindan mo na nagot kan pagkukulang, pwedeng ang pag-repair sa laog ni Binting Aldaw, kung sindan masapo kang pwedeng i-listen ang Aldaw, kasi siguro dapat maanin. Ano po sa ibang kooperatiba, ikaw po kani, nakakontrata na pag may mga sitwasyon na araw ganiyo, ang supplier ang mananagot ka itong mga kakulangan na pwedeng i-supply sa kooperatiba. Igwa po kayo sa ibang igwa. Ano po ta, di ba ka mo nag-uulay-ulay na apat na kooperatiba kan Indirong Provincia?
Yes, you may answer.
Yes, sir. Good.
Please state your name.
Good morning. Good. I'm Mr. Hidalgo. Mr. Hidalgo of Kasoreco 2. Sorry, I'm representing Mr. Adlao. He sends his apologies kasi kahapon po, he was invited to the Congress to explain on the same matter. So, is flying in today pa lang.
Please proceed.
So, yung question ni sir kung bakit hindi kami para sa kanila, actually meron pong offer, yung offer ng supplier namin in January, dalawang klase. Yung isang rate na kami yung maghahanap at times na mawala sila, and isang rate na sila nang bahala. Ang offer po nun, ang difference is 85 centavos per month. Ang mas mataas kung sila maghahanap kahit mawala sila. So according to our simulations, 85 centavos per month times 5 years, malaki pong diferensya yon na i-consider ng Kasoreco 2. Around 450 million increase pa po yun sa rate natin. Yun yung pong offer nila. So to answer your question, sir.
Sa kulangin, isu-isu lang ano, Siguro, sarusan naman ang pangarap ng kasuri ko. Kasuri ko 1, kasuri ko 2, kasuri ko 3, kasuri ko 4. May mga kooperatibo na marayan dalagan kan management. Ano daw kung mag-suggest ang saro o kaya piding i-adapt kang sarong kooperatiba, mag-dos mo yan o 1? Emelan, tingnan mo siya ba?
Actually, kasi po, ang ano mo is, it's more of, he's hiring to supply. Ano po? Ang ano, Kasoreco 3, Kasoreco 4 is being supplied by SMEC, by the San Miguel.
Iba ang supplier.
Iba ang supplier po. So, different supplier, different co-op, different rate. Depende po sa contract na nalawag nila. So, if nalawag nila maray na supplier at a lower rate, then it follows na lower man ang power.
Ining di may ang kooperatiba ba may parang percent ka mo no ining yang 30% ka ang supply koro tangi sa bakman ining yang 30% ka ang supply hali nga igdi sa sarong supplier di po kayang supplier kan same supplier ang apat na kooperatiba
limited ba po ang capacity
di pa kayang supply
kumbaga although ang San Miguel nga tadakot siyang capacity kadakol na naman siya ka-bilateral contracts, well, exhausted na si sayang capacity. Di man siya pwede mag-supply ni over sa sobra kang kaya ninda.
Di mas masurdo itong kooperatiba na nakainod naman sa supplier na mas nabubo ang presyo.
Iya po, galaan po.
Di sa'yo po yung masasurdo ngayon na kooperatiba? O no?
Di ko po gaya nga nag-recommend. Di bawal po kayo mahiling man ang mga prices na 1,000. Kasi nga po, even with the same supplier, different pa rin ang contract price nila.
Okay, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Sa ERC, Honorable Nopra, you are recognized. Siya ko yan, ERC, ano ito nagkakay kong shutdown? Is that mandatory o talagang yearly may shutdown? Ang mga planta.
Merong sinasubmit na schedule of maintenance schedule.
Yun. Yung
mga plant.
That's why merong shutdown dahil may maintenance schedule.
Oh.
So, that's once a year ang shutdown? For how long ang maintenance?
Yung submission ng maintenance shutdown, hindi sa ERC sinasubmit yun, sir.
So,
sa National Grid Corporation of the Philippines at saka sa Department of Energy.
As an equal lang, parang gusto ko lang malaman sa inyo. Every year, talaga meron talaga silang shutdown. Yung mga planta.
May running hours yung mga generator eh. So, pagkatapos ng running hours.
For maintenance.
I-maintain
yes.
Yun.
Like Mid Johnson, December, nag-shutdown sila for the whole month for maintenance. Mm-hmm. Kasi yung machine, araw-araw tumatakbo. Hindi naman pwedeng lifetime o matagal na panahon silang takbo. So, meron talaga siyang full shutdown. Bakit nagkaka-shutdown? Dahil yung for maintenance.
Yes.
Tapos, dyan naman pumapasok ibang players na matataas ang singil. Di ba?
Hindi. Itong sa abnormal itong sa November ang daming nag-force shutdown.
Pero yung ibang mga companies, during the shutdown.
So, supposed to be, ang shutdown niyan, hindi naman magkakasabay-sabay. Dito lang sa November, may mga forced shutdown. Yung sa kanila, maliit lang yun. Hindi nga considered sa ano yung Bachmann. Ang malalaki, yung GN Power na affected yung mga...
Ilan ba lahat yan? Meron ba kayong lahat ng mga ng supplier? Ilan ba lahat yan sa buong Pilipinas? Meron ba kayong lista ng lahat na nagsusupply ng energy?
Meron lista pero wala kaming dala dito.
Meron kayang 100 na suppliers yung independent o kung tawag din niyan? Power. Meron? May 100?
Meron siguro.
Pwede kayo maka-request ng the list of lahat na kung ano mga suppliers?
Actually, sir, sa website ng DOE, meron yun.
Ah, so makikita?
DOE.
Okay. Honorable Nopra?
Thank you, Chairman. Future Vice Governor of the Province of Camarines.
Yes, Mayor Nopra.
First of all, Mr. Chairman, let me assure our guest that I have only three questions. Sir, ito po, I know malice and no offense meant. My first question, Mr. Chairman. Ano po kamo sa kasureko, sa apat na kasureko? Igo kamo reklamo sa ERC?
So far po mayroon.
Mayo kamo reklamo sa ERC. Na pwede po matanong ko ngayon, mga taga-ERC po kayo. Sir, this is if you have any knowledge. Do you remember of any instance where the ERC disapproved? Not even once, huh? Even once. Any application for the rates increase yung mga kasureko dito sa Kamarinisur from 1 to 4. Kung may naalala po kayo na dinasapprove nyo yung kanilang kailangan. Kasi po, ang mandate nyo, sir, malinaw po, tarif, hawak nyo yun, may control kayo doon. May naalala po ba kayo na niminsan may dinasapprove kayo?
As far as kasureko, kasureko 1 to 4 is
concerned. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sir,
I'm not sure na may pababa. Pero nationwide po ang mga taripa na minomonitor namin and inaproban.
No, sir.
Meron po sa Ilocos.
I'm not asking you about Ilocos or about any region or about any cooperative outside of the province. My question is very clear. You see, sir, I would like to inform you. Kasureko started in Libmanan. I am from Libmanan. That's Kasureko 1. Now my question is very clear. 1, 2, 3, 4. Of any instance where the ERC disapproved their application for rates increase. Kasi my first question was very clear. It was answered clearly by the gentleman there. Wala silang reklamo sa ERC. Ngayon po ako magtatanong sa inyo. May naalala po ba kayo na application ng alinman sa mga Kasureko na dinisapprove nyo?
You may answer from the ERC, please.
Kamarinisur lang tayo, sir.
May yes, sir. Clear yung question nyo. Dinisapprove na
application nila.
Pataas, sir.
Natural po, hindi naman siya nag-apply po, babae.
Meron, sir.
O meron saan? Sa Kamarinisur?
Hindi nga po sa
Kamarinisur. Let's not talk about other provinces or other places.
Okay, ang sagot po doon ay wala.
Wala. So, Mr. Chairman, my first question was answered very clearly. In all honesty, that wala silang reklamo ang mga kasureko sa ERC. Satisfied ako duman. Ngunyan po ang hapot man po ko, iskadwa akong hapot, simbag man po. Tapos na, sir. Mabago ka, sir. Simbag. Tapos na, patapos ako, sir.
Okay.
I still have the floor.
Okay. Okay, sige. Please proceed, Honorable Nakla.
Now, the answer of the ERC, duman sa hapot ko po, tayo na, dadawag ng Kamarinisur, kung may igwa na lamang si Tapig disapprove, sa rin man aplikasyon, ang simbag man po ninda, mayo po sindang nagigirunduman. So, mayo. Ano po? Mayong mali siya po, sanapot ko. Just asking. Now, sir, you have any questions?
Just to clarify.
Yes, Manager Abunal.
Ba po si Belday pwedeng aprobal? Because without the approval, there will be no unbounded rates. Just to clarify.
Sir, iulitin mo ka, sir.
Hindi po. Mayo pong, they pwedeng, mayo pong power rate na na-approved kang ERC. Because without their approval, there'll be no unbounded rates. So what the ERC is doing is not disapproving, they're actually reducing. If we apply for a 7, or say, magsabi ka ganyan, distribution charge fee would be 2 pesos. Sabi kang ERC, upon their study, ang dapat lang ngayon do is 150, they will approve only 150. So there is no such thing as disapproval. There is only a reduction.
No, sir. I don't believe you're right.
Yan po actually nangyari.
That is your opinion, ha? That is your opinion. You see, ang hapot ko kayo sa dapat pigadalan mo sa namaray. Ang hapot ko sa inyo malinawon. Kung ikos yung dampig di sa turubaran, duman sa increase na inagat yung arinman na kasureko. Malinaw po ba kayong simbag? Mayo. Tapos na, sir. Ang simple dito po pwede pisilon. Yo. Ang simbag rinda, mayo. Gusto nyo sabi yun, paghagad ng dos, tinawa si dos. Paghagad ng piso, bawa kasi ito, ERC nga yun dapat magsimbag. Kaya po tayo may problema ka sa ERC, mayo. Oh. Yes, sir, madina po. Sir, salamat po sa simbag mo. Salamat, sir, sa sagot nyo. Now, pwede po, sir, salamat po ito lang po.
Yes,
Mayor. Kasi po, in fairness naman sa mga sisipag na nagtatrabaho sa ARC, your boss po is, sino po yung boss na? Senaida Dokot, a former congresswoman from Pampanga. Po? Is it true that there is no popular clamor for her to resign? At kung totoo po yun, bakit kaya? Meron po ba kayong may bibigyan ng ideas sa amin? Please sir, ano ba? Personal na, kahit konti lang po, walang personal lang po dito. Yung ano nyo lang, opinion nyo.
In deference to our chair.
Fairness to her.
Hindi po kami magko-comment.
Ha? Okay.
Hindi po kami authorized mag-comment at hindi po kami magko-comment ako sa bagay na yun. Pasensya na po.
Okay. Now, Mr. Chairman, ako kasi, una ko man po kita, mga taga-ARC Sinda, parati bagay na ang boss mo, pigdi-depensa mo. This is the first time na, o sabay, hindi ko sila ma-blame. Senda man yan. But one thing for sure, Mr. Chairman. Total, ang Camarines Sugar Room, maman problema sa ARC. Ang ARC, maman pinidisapprove sa mga pigagad na increase kang apat na cooperative bagang kasureko. Ilingundan lang po sa maabot na panahon, Mr. Chairman. Okay. Nagpapasalamat na lang po ko, tapos hindi nagdigdingo niyan. Thank you po sa inyo. Malayo pang pinagbiyayan nyo. Sendo sir, ma'am. Sisir ganyan sa kasureko, Juan.
Representative, please.
Mr. Chairman, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, thank you. Who else would I? Majority floor leader. Okay, last comment. Okay, Honorable Manny Noble, you're recognized.
Sir, last small question to address to the Energy Regulatory Commission. Sir, would you mind na once na may mga information pertaining to that Kasareco co-op, pwede kami ma-permission ninyo ng mga, ano, mga data? Pertinente para at least aware yung province para mayroon tayong constant ano na itong mga co-op natin para makatulong din kami in the part of the province of Camarines Sur. Pwedeng i-address na lang through the Vice Governor office na pertaining sa mga relevant sa mga co-op namin dito sa Kasareco 3.
Sir, pwedeng mahingi okay. Na lang yung official na email address.
Yes.
Pwede namin ipadala.
Do you have an office here in Naga?
Wala, wala.
So, all of you, the three of you came from Manila?
Yes. Manila.
Just to attend this session? Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank
then,
you.
Then, last address to the Kasareco 3. Madam, mayroon tayo ngayon pagputol na naman yung ano, schedule na ano bang update natin sa Kasareco 3?
Wala po.
Wala tayo ngayon? Assured ang Kasareco 3 na wala tayong treat sa mga disconnection? Okay, thank you. And then, sa Kasareco 4 naman, meron kayong request for approval, no? Address to Vice Governor
yes, sir.
Tupenya.
We are asking for the certificate.
Importante yun sa part ng...
Opo,
sir, you are from what?
Kasareco 4.
Kasareco 4. And you are...
My name is Jean Vares, the Billing Section Head and the Regulatory Compliance Officer of Kasareco 4, sir. I'm here to represent Attorney Briones.
Okay.
So being the Chairman of the Committee on Energy, kasi na-refer to, very urgent on the part of Kasareco 4.
Yes, thank you.
So, in behalf, Mr. Chairman, thank you very much to the group of the Energy Regulatory Commission from Manila, nag-travel sila from Manila. So, I do hope na siguro mas maganda kung ma-regionalize ang ano ninyo office para naman kung may mga ano kami, mas maganda, no? Siguro sa future, baka mayroon tayong mga ano na dito sa Region 5 para mas madali. So, ang cover ninyo, pertinent lang sa power lang or what about sa ano itong iba? Ano lang, yun lang ang ano nyo? So, okay, we have no more question, Mr. Chairman.
There are no more questions.
Thank you.
And we would like to thank you,
Mr. Chairman.
Majority floor leader.
Ang nakalagay din sa notice, they are from NEA. Actually, ERC pala, Linda. ERC. kabo po yung board na nag-approve ng petition for increase or decrease?
Yes, yes.
Kasi I thought, Mr. Chairman, they are from NEA. Sila pala ERC. So when query lang, Mr. Chairman,
you may proceed.
When a cooperative apply for a petition for increase or decrease or payment, itong mga overpayment, does your office conduct a hearing?
Dumadaan po yan sa board. Initial process.
Opo. So may hearing po, may hearing.
Magana, mag-hearing.
Oh. And according to Mr. Rabunal, actually you do not disapprove, but you just reduce. Then the basis of that reduction, maybe, is based on the evaluation of ERC.
Evaluation.
Is there a time or a situation, Mr. Chairman, that a petition or somebody or like the consumer would like to oppose the call for the increase? Can they submit papers?
Yes, sir. Actually, yung famous na si Pete Ilagan, madalas siya mag-oppose. Yung president ng National Association for Residential...
From where is that, Mr. Pete Ilagan?
From Tacloban. Pero merong local chapter yan dito sa Naga.
So he became famous because he keep on opposing?
Yes.
Become a famous, you oppose the increase. Mr. Chairman, actually, so there can be a possibility of, say for example, if there is an opposition, and a petition for an increase or decrease may not be granted by ERC.
Depends on the merit of the case. Karamihan naman kasi ng case is in accordance with the rules of the commission. So hindi naman sila magpa-file ng mga...
That's why.
Mga,
so it becomes ministerial on the part of ERC to grant or not. To increase or not.
Yes.
So the letter of opposition is just a scrap of paper.
So titingnan naman natin yung merit, sir.
That's why we are asking that, Mr. Chairman, because we keep on receiving letters from the petitioner. Wala ho kaming gagawin lang, sabi nyo, sabi daw nila. Lalagay lang namin sa blackboard yung petition. Yun lang ang gagawin. And the provincial secretary will certify. Wala kaming gagawin. So, kaya nga siguro wala, Mr. Chairman, ERC keep on approving petition kasi hindi tayo nagre-reklamo. The sanggunian palalawigan has to do is just to post that request sa billboard. Wala kaming gagawin kasi according to the cooperatives, yun lang ang naming ang role. When we receive, the provincial secretary certifies, the provincial secretary place that petition just sa blackboard. Wala tayong gagawin, Mr. Chairman. Kaya, hindi po kayo nakaka-receive ng opposition man lang galing sa sanggunian. Yun daw po ang role lang. So, sabi namin, hindi pwede yan simula ngayon. Kasi, ang estimate namin, kaya ginagrant nyo, hindi nagre-reklamo yung mga LGU. Kasi ang sabi nyo, doon sa inyong policy, memorandum, the only role of the sanggunian is to place that petition in the blackboard, bulletin board, and the provincial secretary certifies. Ganyan lang po ang sabi ng cooperative, yun daw ang requirements nyo. Kaya nga, when the cooperative submits the letter, in few days, magsisimula na ang hearing. So, we have no time to oppose. We have no time to delay. So, kaya ang provincial secretary minamadali na mag-certify para lang only to show from to ERC na nag-comply ang mga cooperatives. So, ganun po ang sistema nyo. Wala po kaming karapatan mag-oppose.
Any stakeholders are given the chance at pwede po kayo. Hindi po namin sinasabi na hindi pwede.
Tingnan niyo po yung memo niyo.
Yung memo, sir, this is as regards to their compliance as to the posting. Kailangan po nilang i-post yun para makita ng iba at kung kailangan magkomento o maging
parte o oppositor dun sa case ay mabasa yon at mag-appear sa actual na pagdinig or paghihirap.
So this is for the record, Mr. Chairman. There are, even before, cooperative would say, ang gagawin lang natin is ministerial. The provincial secretary certifies that there is a letter coming from the petitioner, and what the secretary will do is to post that in the bulletin board. Only that man ang gagawin iba, Mr. Chairman. In fact, many times, Mr. Chairman, petition or letter coming from cooperative comes a day before the hearing or one working day. Yung wala ka ng time para mag-upos, Mr. Chairman, kasi ministerial lang on our part. In fact, the board secretary, Attorney Figuracion, was even reprimanded by one board member. Ang gagawin mo lang mag-certify. Wala ka ng ibang gagawin. That is from cooperative form. Iyan po. Iyan ang gustong mangyari kan partido. Magpirma sana ang provincial secretary. Mayo ng ibang gigibuhon.
You may answer, sir, please. You may answer.
Sir, gusto ko lang pong sabihin or inform everybody that capital po is our entrepreneur, one of our entrepreneurs in our CAPEX application. So, talaga pong ang nag-entrepreneur man po ang CAPEX.
Sorry lang po.
Actually, sir, we still in hearing pa po. Capital po is one of our entrepreneurs.
Okay. So, at least our provincial secretary is informed of that. And the Sangguniang is informed of that. Bako pong ministerial sa party kan Sangguniang palalawigan ang maglaag sa naning petition sa bulletin board saka mag-certify. Dakol minang several times minang kinontra. Several times na namin pinag. Kaya lang, it seems na based on ERC memorandum, all we have to do is to certify and post that in the bulletin board. Yun lang pong gagawin namin. So, in fact, sabi namin, starting 2014, we will not accede with that kind of system. We have to verify. Kasi, kaya po siguro ina-approve kasi hindi nagre-reklamo ang tao. Even the Sangguniang Palalawigan does not oppose. Kasi ina-approve namin. Kasi yun lang doon rule. Mag-certify lang ang provincial secretary. Mr. Chairman, I thought kay ni Yai, dahil ko aram na ERC kaya palanso niya on. Na the one of the reason, Mr. Chairman, why we created the Committee on Franchises. So this time po, kung gusto po, kung you have petitions, meron na kaming special committee, additional committee on franchises, which will hear, ano po. Kung nasa right man po, baga wala namang problema kung ano. Pero, May misnomer lang. It seems that the provincial government, especially the Sangguniang Palalawigan, has no opposition or has nothing to say about the increases. Kaya siguro perminang approve or disapprove or whatever. Di kami nagigirong kasi sabi kaya wala kaming role. Just to post it in the bulletin board. Yun lang po yan.
Okay, you're done. So
for the information, for the information of the body, sir, noong October 2012, in one of the hearings of our contracts, yung Therma Luzon contract namin, one of the oppositors was the provincial capital represented by the legal counsel. And from Naga, si Attorney Miles Rakid. So, in the future, siguro, we'll put in the letters that you're open to submit your comments and your oppositions to the petition para mas malinaw po.
That's why. Pero, thank you, sir. So we would like to inform the cooperatives, the four cooperatives, kindly for this as copies earlier of time. Kasi if you will review, Mr. Chairman, kung mag-submit ko niyan, next week na yan ang hearing. Or mag-submit ko niyan, sa Friday na ang hearing. So how can we evaluate those petitions, Mr. Chairman? So, if you can, at least kunyan aram na po nindo, na bako ministerial ang role kan Sangguniang Palalawigan with regards to the information given to the Sangguniang Palalawigan.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman.
Okay. I just want to ask the representative from the ERC, how do you compute the systems loss? You said it's pegged to 13%. 13% of what?
13% of the total or of the generation charge or what?
13% of the kilowatt hours purchased from the generators. Kilowatt hours purchased, yung source nila ng power, kilowatt hours, hindi amount.
Ah, hindi yung marireflect sa bill.
Hindi.
Doon ang computation ninyo. 13% of
the kilowatt hours purchased.
Yung purchase. Hindi naman namin malalaman yun.
Pwede
how do you compute that? Pwede ba may narrow down? Sa bill namin, makikita ba?
Hindi makikita yun, sir.
The 13%
rate na lang ang makikita doon.
Ah, yung rate na lang.
Pero chine-check namin yon. Tapos, periodic verification kung may over or under recovery.
Anong parte diyan sa bill? Yung galing dun sa supplier na chine-check sa 13% of doon. Anong parte diyan?
Generation.
So, generation lang.
Generation kilowatt hours.
Yan lang?
Yung total.
Yung total. So, in other words, so, alam namin yung lahat na sinusupplyan nila and then you will be multiplying with this itong generation charge, makikita namin yung consumption nila.
Hindi, ano sir, ang kilowatt hours purchase less kilowatt hours sales, yung difference is system loss.
So like for this one, kagaya nito.
Kunyari sir, ang binili na lang kilowatt hours purchase nila sa supplier is 20 million kilowatt hours. Hmm. Ang nabenta nila eh 15 million. So meron siyang loss na 5 million. So yung 5 million na yun, ilang percent ng 20 million yun?
Kung kami consumer, how would we know na sobra na sa 13% ang tina-charge nila?
Pwede nyo namang tanungin sa cooperative nyo eh, sir. Kung paano nila
kinukumpute.
Per month ang computation nun, sir.
Aside from the cooperative, saan kami pwedeng malalaman nyo na kung nag-exceed sa 13% o 10% lang, kung ano ang kwan? ERC pwede ba? Sa NEA?
Pwede sa amin, sir. Kaya lang, yung kanilang submission is nakalag ng 1 month. Eh. So, yung December, isasubmit pa sa amin ng January 31 yan.
Oh, next question, yung point ko lang. Kasi sabi kasi ninyo, explanation ninyo nung earlier, na yung mga generation charge, pwede sila parang meron na silang authority na mag-increase. Later on, saka na lang, i-assess ng...
Yes.
So, papasok kayo, after the increase, saka lang kayo papasok to assess.
Yes.
Kung sobra yung increase, di ba?
Yes, sir.
Sa anong parte kayo papasok? Like, for example, this month, nag-increase sila sa generation charge dahil nakabili ng kwan?
Magpa-file, merong schedule na application, may schedule yan, sir, na application for over under recoveries sa pass-through charges. So, ngayong March 31, magpa-file lahat ng Luzon for the years 2011 to 2013.
Hmm.
3 years yung verification. Yun yung i-confirm namin. Kasi
yung, so in other words, hindi naman pala yung wala palang prior approval.
Kasi sir, nasa rules siya. May automatic yan. Automatic adjustment.
So they can increase anytime, okay lang.
Pero
after so many months, saka lang natin i-assess kung tama. Am I correct? May understanding?
Yes, sir. Actually, dala ko yung rules eh. Na may copy ako ng rules dito.
So, walang prior approval yung increase?
Wala. Kasi, sir, ano yan eh. Covered yan yung...
So, yung krimen, pwedeng gawin na. I-assess natin yung krimen later on.
Actually, sir, lalabas lahat ng decision ng apat sila. Lalabas yung decision ng apat na kasureko. Lalabas na yun. Within this month, hindi ko lang alam yung ano.
So, nag-a-apply sila?
Kailangan, mandated sila mag-apply.
Mag-apply? Nung ano nakaraan na taon?
Nung nakaraan na taon.
Ah, yun lang i-apply kung tama yung 2014.
And the thing, post-audit.
Post-audit. So, 2013.
Kasi hindi namin kaya administratively na mag-verify monthly. Kasi ang may hawak lang yan, 16 na tao, ilan ng utility sa buong Pilipinas.
So meron pa kayo hanggang ngayon yung 2011 na hindi pa nyo nakukuhan yung 2011.
Oh, ipa-file nila ng 20 ngayong March 31 yung 2011.
So pag-uuna pa rin yun by March yung mga ginawa ng 2011.
Yes, sir.
And then mag-a-apply na naman yung 2012 hindi pa.
Hindi, kasama yun, sir. 11 to 13.
12 and 13. So yung 3 years yung by March na nag-apply. Yun lang malalaman yung termin doon.
Yung sa, from 2004 to 2010, lalabas na desisyon yan.
So, kung sobra, when you assess ninyo, 11, 12, 13, sobra yung sovereign, yung kwan nila, pagpatong nila, so, ibitag nila sa baba. Hindi. Anong mangyayari doon? Anong gagawin nila?
Refund.
Magre-refund yung?
Magre-refund sila sa customer.
Ah, ganun ba yun?
Generation transmission system loss.
Manager Abunal, meron bang instance na yung mga consumers nagkaroon tayo ng refund dahil doon pag-assessan niya ng ERC? Kahit hindi ngayon, mga noon mga nakaraang mga taon, meron ba tayo ng refund?
Meron na. Actually, it was reflected this power sa power bill.
Ah, sa bill naka-reflect yun?
Mandated, yung mandated reduction.
Okay, ganun pala yun. And the majority floor leader.
Finally, Mr. Chairman, to the best of your knowledge po, maybe no, sino po yung nagpapatakbo ng WESEN headed by Secretary Pitilla? Sino ang, po yung ang government board, ang bigwigs na nakaupo? Si Dokot po, si Mrs. Dokot.
Hindi kami, hindi kasama ang ERC sa WESEN.
Ay, hindi ko kasali. Sino yung nagsishare ng income? Sino? Kasi sabi niyo private. Pero sabi ni Manager Aldao, Adlao, government daw po yung WESEN. Pero sabi niya po, private. Private ang WESEN funded by the government. Ganun ho yun? Anyway, hindi, kasi may law siguro ho yan. Kaya lang, tanungin lang ho, tapagkatapos, yung income ho pala doon, pinaghati-hati ng mga generator, ano po? Eh, tingnan mo yun, pwedeng, yung kasi pagka-WESEN po kasi mahal. Ano?
Hindi naman si market ang may income, yung trading ng mga participants.
Yun po, pero malinaw niyo, are you sure na yan o, privado?
Privado, funded by government? Privado ang PEMC, funded by the participants kasi nagbabayad sila ng market fees.
Pagkatapos po, yung to the best of your knowledge, malinaw ang chairman si Secretary Pitilla. Sino pa hong mga taga-gobyerno ang kasali? Na ang kausap ng mga privado.
Ang president naman ng PEMC, yung market operator, si Melinda Ocampo, yung dating chair ng ERB.
Oh, sila yung gumawa ng mekanismo sa WESEN, di ba? Kung paano magkaroon ng mekanismo. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, tinatanong lang natin kasi this is a national issue kung hindi yun sa probinsya. Kaya lang po, ang epekto sa probinsya, masyadong grabe. Ano po? Kasi wala kang choice, pupunta ka doon sa mahal. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, okay. Thank you.
What's your pleasure now, the majority floor leader?
If there will be no more query from the members, I move for a one-minute recess, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Thank you very much. Before I declare a one-minute recess, thank you very much from the ERC and the Casoreco. Thank you very much for coming. Recess for 2 minutes. Salamat po. From Manila pa pala sila.
Ito, mag-imbita. Mag-imbita mamaya.
Basta initially funded yan. Thank you.
F
Majority Floor Leader.
F2A Inclusion of Vulnerable Naban.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I move that this be referred to the Committee on Ways and Means, Mr. Chairman.
Is there any second to the motion? Is duly seconded? Any objections? Hearing none, the motion of Honorable Naval is approved.
F3.
Majority Floor Leader.
F3.
Mr. Chairman, there is here a letter. Ako na mabasa. This is in connection, Mr. Chairman, with our request with the President, Office of the President, for 4 fire boats and 20 fire trucks. According to Ms. Nora C. Oliveros, Deputy Executive Secretary of the Finance and Administration Office of the Office of the President, there is an endorsement that said resolution was referred or endorsed to the Secretary of DILG, Manuel A. Rojas III, regarding the resolution coming from the Sangguniang Panlalawigan of the province of Camarines. So, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, duly noted. Honorable Nopra, you're recognized.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. This has something to do with the FTA.
F3A?
Oh, the letter that was read by Board Member Naban.
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, Resolution Number 881, Series of 2013. I was the one who sponsored this resolution, Mr. Chairman. So, upon... And now, Mr. Chairman, if the Chair will allow me, if the Chair will allow me this representation, I would like to sponsor another resolution, Mr. Chairman. This time, this resolution is addressed to Secretary Manuel Rojas II.
You may proceed.
Thank you for allowing me, Mr. Chairman. The rationale behind, Mr. Chairman, is that first, we are about to commemorate or celebrate the, what you call the Fire Prevention Month. And the fact remains that many municipalities in the province of Camarines, they don't have good fire trucks. Many of the fire trucks now are unserviceable, and many municipalities they cannot afford to provide for their own because of their limited budget. So here is an opportunity, Mr. Chairman, to ask once more from the national government to help the province of Camarines. So, Mr. Chairman, with that rationale, I would like to sponsor now a resolution earnestly requesting Secretary Manuel A. Rojas II to provide the province of Camarines 4 fire boats and 20 fire trucks and firefighting equipments, Mr. Chairman. And hopefully...
The motion, the motion?
I'm now moving for its approval, Mr. Chairman.
Is there any second to the motion? Is duly seconded? Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Majority Floor Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Now, with regards to F3B, Mr. Chairman, I move that this be noted.
It's duly noted.
And on F3C, I move that this be referred to the Committee on Laws and Review.
Referred to Committee on Laws and Review.
And also, Mr. Chairman, on F3D, may I ask the Provincial Secretary whether the one I included under business for today is the same with this F3D, Mr. Chairman?
The provincial secretary may answer.
Coming from the DBP.
The provincial secretary may answer. The query
in my inclusion, Mr. Chairman, I move for the inclusion of two items. The first one is the resolution and the second one is an ordinance, all relating to one subject matter, Mr. Chairman. But in this resolution,
hindi mo na-identified po ba dyan? Iba man po yan. Mayo po. Ay. This one.
Anyway, Mr. Chairman, I move that this be referred to the this be transferred to G5 under calendar of business so that later on we can consolidate if ever this is of similar
item. Referred to calendar of business.
No, transfer.
Transferred.
Transferred to transfer calendar to of business under business.
Business for the day.
On review of municipal and city resolutions and ordinances, Mr. Chairman, we have six items. I move that this be referred to appropriate committees as marked.
Referred to appropriate committees.
Calendar of business, committee report, committee, joint committee report on committee on public safety and disaster and environmental protection and committee on loss and review.
Mr. Chairman, we have here a joint committee report by the Committee on Public Safety and Disaster Management and Committee on Loss and Review, headed by, as chaired by Board Member Simando. This is in connection with an ordinance implementing forced evacuation as a resort when a disaster or emergency has been declared and danger of loss of lives becomes imminent, providing penalties therefore and for other purposes. This is an ordinance, Mr. Chairman, coming from the municipality of Tigaon. Finding the ordinance to be valid, the Joint Committee hereby recommends that said ordinance be approved, Mr. Chairman. With this, in collaboration with Board Member Simando, I move that this committee report, Joint Committee report, be approved, Mr. Chairman.
Is there any second to the motion? It is duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Also, Mr. Chairman, this is a joint committee report of the Committee on Ways and Means and Committee on Laws and Review. This is in connection with the ordinance coming from the municipality of Goa, an ordinance fixing the rental rates and manner of awarding the stalls in the newly constructed building in Phase 1 and 2 of the Goa public market and for other purposes. Recommendations that after due consideration of the foregoing, the Joint Committee hereby recommends for the approval of the ordinance. Upon recommendation, approval of the committee, the chairman and the members of the Committee on Laws and Review and the Committee on Ways and Means, Mr. Chairman, I move that this Joint Committee report be approved by the members.
Is there any second to the motion? It is duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
The committee report of Honorable Simando.
Honorable Simando is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, this is a committee report concerning resolution ordinances coming from five different municipalities. This committee report consists of five items. All the members of this August body have been duly furnished with copies of this report. May I move for the approval of the same?
There any second to the motion? It is duly seconded. In objections, hearing none, the motion is approved. Majority floor leader.
On business for the day, Mr. Chairman, we have a resolution. May we request our provincial secretary to please?
The provincial secretary is directed to read.
Upon instruction, Mr. Chairman, of our provincial vice governor, he told me that we are going to request the Honorable Congressman Lenny Robredo to cause the conversion of the herein below listed provincial roads located in the municipality of Calabaga, Camarines. This listing were submitted by Vice Mayor Ramon Robles And the Vice Governor instructed me to pass this resolution so that those listed roads can be converted from municipal, provincial roads to national roads, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, we go to the next item, Mr. Chairman. Later on, if our provincial secretary is able to find the copy of said resolution.
Okay, next item.
The inclusion of Honorable Simando.
Honorable Simando, you are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a resolution authorizing Sylvia T. Banyaris, Administrative Officer, Presentation Municipal Hospital, to enter into a memorandum of agreement with Kasoriko 4, Talohong Muntigang Kamarnisor for electric service connection. Mr. Chairman, we move for the approval of this resolution.
Is there any second to the motion? It is duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Commissioner Honorable Pacamara.
Honorable Pacamara, you're recognized.
Mr. Chairman, Hong Kong Chief Executive Leung Chung Ying issued an order that starting February 5, 2014, the current visa-free arrangement between them and the Philippine government for visiting diplomats and officials will be suspended in their initial phase of sanctions to the Philippine government for refusing to issue an apology as an outcome of the hostage-taking incident in Manila last 2010. So, with this, Mr. Chairman, I decided to pass a resolution leading the Hong Kong government through Honorable Governor Miggs Villaforte not to impose restrictions and to spare the province overseas Filipino workers from securing visa. So, with this, Mr. Chairman, and the members of this chamber were furnished a copy of this draft resolution. With this, Mr. Chairman, I move for the approval of proposed resolution number 1070.
Is there any second to the motion? It's duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
The inclusion of Honorable Nabal.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. I would like to consolidate the one transfer, Mr. Chairman, from the circulars going to the business per day together with my inclusion. Mr. Chairman, so, Mr. Chairman, there is here a letter coming from the branch head, Mrs. Verdadero. This is in connection with our pending loan, original loan, before Governor Miggs Villaforte came in. So, mga nainot pa na nawalat, Mr. Chairman, for there were some revisions in BSP requirements. Kaya, when the new leadership came in, and he would like to continue the program because there are pending programs not being implemented because of this pending release. So they manifested, the new leadership in the person of Honorable Miggs Villaforte, manifested to continue with our existing loan. But the DBP man, Naga Branch, Mr. Chairman, made some documentary requirements so that this can be continued. And one of that is a Sanggunian resolution authorizing the updating of deposit account and designating the official signatories thereon. So, Mr. Chairman, this is now my first resolution, my first inclusion under business for the day. This is a resolution authorizing the provincial governor to represent the province to enter into a contract with the Development Bank of the Philippines to sign the loan agreement, deed of assignment, the promissory note, and other documents related thereto. In fact, Mr. Chairman, I am told that this resolution form was made by the DBP. So, we will just do it, Mr. Chairman, in our formal form, then let them adjust, Mr. Chairman. So in this resolution, the signature of the governor, Mr. Chairman, should be incorporated. It should be part of the resolution, Mr. Chairman. This is different kind, wherein the specimen of the governor should be incorporated in the resolution as part of the requirement of DPP. And also, designating Ms. Leia M. Samson, the provincial budget office, as the second signatory of that said document, Mr. Chairman. So with this, Mr. Chairman, I move for its approval.
Is there any second to the motion? This duly seconded. In objection, hearing none, the motion is approved.
The next, Mr. Chairman, is the ordinance in relation to the same subject matter, Mr. Chairman, wherein we are adopting the BSP, new BSP rules, and also the revitalization or the renewal of the conditions made, because we have a new governor, we have the new sets of provincial officials. So with this, Mr. Chairman, I move that the ordinance related to that subject matter be approved.
So any second to the motion? It is duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
What about, sir?
Baman?
The resolution, sir.
So, other matters?
The resolution. Requesting Honorable Maria
Leonor
Lerona Robred.
I thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a resolution requesting Honorable Maria Leonor Leni Rona Robredo, House of Representatives of the 3rd District of Camarines, through Honorable Rogelio L. Singson, Secretary of the Department of Public Works and Highway, to cause the conversion of the herein listed below listed provincial roads located in the municipality of Calabanga. This is La Purisima to Sibao Road Section, Sibao to Lugsad Binanuan and Pequeño Kamuning Mangiring Section. These are all, Mr. Chairman, provincial and municipal roads to be converted to national roads, Mr. Chairman. So with this, I together with Board Member Julia, as my co-sponsor, I move for its approval, Mr. Chairman.
Is there any second to the motion? Is duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Other matters?
Honorable Julia, you are recognized.
Mr. Chairman, a letter from Sangguni Ambayan member, Municipality of Magarao, from the office of Councilor Antonio Camalia, attached is the copy of Magarao Cockpit Ordinance. Permission to read, Mr. Chairman. Address to the Vice Chairman, Games and Amusement Committee. Sangguniang Panlalawigan, Camarines Sur, Philippines. Dear Bukal Julia, this is just a query of the legality of cockfighting days in Magarao, Camarines Sur. As per resolution number 04128 and approved municipal ordinance number 2004-04, Section 8 states that place and holding of cockfights may be held only in a licensed cockpit and in the place authorized by municipal government. The local chief executive shall issue the necessary permits on regular and special cockfights as follows. Letter A. For regular cockfights during Sundays, Saturdays, and legal holidays, except on the following days, window cockfights should be held. Holy Thursday, Good Friday, election referendum and registration day of such election or referendum. Letter B, for not more than 3 consecutive days and not more than once a year during or in connection with barangay fiestas as fixed by the Sangguniang barangays in accordance with Republic Act 7160 or Local Government Code of 1991 upon resolution of the Sangguniang barangay concerned in the barangay or fiestas are held. Letter C, for not more than 3 consecutive days and not more than once a month on the occasion of the agricultural, commercial, or industrial fairs, carnivals, or exposition upon resolution of barangay and the municipal Sangguniang where such fair, carnival, or exposition is to be held. My understanding is that other than Saturdays and Sundays before the cockpit owner get meals permit, necessary requirements are needed from the barangay and the municipal Sangguniang in the case of holding another days another than approved Saturdays and Sundays. Report shows that the cockpit arena in Magarao, Camarines Sur is continuously operating every Wednesday and Friday without necessary requirement the barangay resolution and the resolution of the Sangguniang Bayan. Another query is the legality of operation of Hialay with business address at Sun 4 at Santo Tomas, Magarao, Camarines Sur, although they have mayor's permit to operate as Hialay, but the manner of operation in the same with the illegal waiting operation. In view of this, may we request assistance on how to control such operation stated above for the 2 gambling business operation in Magarao, Camarines Sur. Mr. Chairman, upon receive of this letter, nagpasyara ko sa Sangguniang Bayan. Sabi ko po sa inda, may puder ka mo na mag sita kani. And sabi po kong sekretary sa Sangguniang Bayan, in-invite in the present ka na COP sa Senang Decision na pipaabot na ang sharing ka niyong problema, alagad mayo po ng aksyon. Kaya, siguro sa pagtubod kang Sangguniang Bayan kan munisipyo kan Magarao, pinabot po sa tuya ang sharing ka niyong Kuya Rininda. And in connection with this, Mr. Chairman, I would like to request through the August body to invite Police Senior Rodolfo Oliver of Magarao PNP concerning the letter coming from Honorable Antonio Camalla of Sangguniang Bayan, Magarao, Camarines Sur regarding the illegal operation of cockfighting in Magarao cockpit arena during Wednesdays and Fridays, which is a violation to the approved cockfighting ordinance of said municipality. Likewise, Mr. Chairman, a letter of appeal be made addressed to Provincial Director Ramiro Bausa, PNP Camsur, to pass an order for the appearance of Police Senior Inspector Oliver on our next session, February 18, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman,
we have an invited guest. May I know from the provincial secretary? Yes, Majority
Floor Leader. For 1 minute, recess.
Okay, recess for 1 minute.
Si ano po, Police Superintendent Bausa.
Siya? Siya? Hold on. Ah.
Next session.
The session resumes.
Mr. Chairman,
yes, Honorable
I-committee label ko na muna ang...
Are you going to be invited in your committee?
Yes, yes, Mr. Chairman.
Okay.
Kuya, the committee on games and amusement, Mr. Chairman. Okay. We will endorse the letter to the committee on...
Chairman committee on games and amusement.
If the chairman is not available, the vice chairman, you know, we should not disturb the chairman.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, Majority Floor Leader.
Another, Mr. Chairman, is that with regards to the order of business in our session, as I earlier said, maybe siguro ipabasa ta kini ki Vice Governor kasi alangan man nagaro bagong ta ulit. As per request of our Vice Governor na inutuntaan prayer after the national anthem, kaya lang I would like to submit the reference, Mr. Chairman, where these rules was based, ano po, itong template kang local government code na hindi nakalaag, inot ang national anthem, then sunod ang prayer. And House of Representative man, inot ang national anthem, tapos ang prayer. So, I am submitting this, Mr. Chairman, to the provincial secretary for her to discuss with the Vice Governor. Tanganing dire-diretso na, depende, ano, may pigsususog lang kaya kita, baka kaya kung may implication man ini, baka igwa man yung rationale behind why is it that the national anthem is ahead from the prayer. So I'm submitting
the provincial secretary is directed to receive the documents from Honorable Lawal and further you are instructed to confer with the Vice Governor.
Administrative cases for appropriate action.
In administrative cases, Mr. Chairman, I move that the two items under administrative cases be referred to the committee on, to the special committee on administrative cases.
Is there any second to the motion? Is there seconded? Is referred to the committee on administrative cases.
Adjournment.
If there will be no more issues to be discussed, Mr. Chairman, I move to adjourn.
Is duly seconded? The session is adjourned.